thing. Which, you know, I'm super happy with. Second out of the water, second off the bike, second over the finish line. You know, I held it together. I had a really strong race. I came into this race feeling really good. I had a really good lead up. But honestly, I mean, Angela deserves every bit of the win. I went with her on the bike when she passed me, and that really cost me on the run. My run was slower than I've been doing in training, but I had nothing. Like, it was all spent on the bike, so to hang in the second and convincing second, I was very happy with that. And you know, for me, obviously I just had to validate the Kona, but I really wanted to have a good result here, which I've done. And for me, it's a good indicator of where things are going this year, how the training's going, and what I need to tweak now for Kona. I feel is definitely things I can improve on, and I think I'm in the right direction for sure. I find it horrible humid at all. I know it was, but I've just been training so much in these conditions in Miami, so I didn't really feel them extreme at all. I think the hardest part for me was, and I think for everybody, is just the run is on hard surfaces and it really beats up your legs. But obviously there was, we're all in the same boat, and there was a lot of aid stations out there and everything to help us through the run. And it was actually a really fun run, lots of great crowds. I haven't raced the 70.3 Worlds for a couple of years because last year they're in Canada, which was, you know, pretty mild climate, and then this year they're going over to Austria, which is mild climate. And you know, I know what I'm good at, and that's racing in the heat. So that's where I sort of put my energy.